So, you've got your Raspberry Pi set up, few important things up and running, and you don't want to lose all the work you've done so far. And you've probably heard that SD card, from which Raspberry Pi is running by default, isn't the most reliable technology. So, what are you going to do? I'll provide you with some options in this video, links up in the corner. But for now, the most pressing matter is, how do I backup the whole Pi, the whole SD card? Well, I'm going to show you exactly how. Welcome! Hi there, it's Wee from Helping Ninja. In this video, I'm going to show you how to backup your SD card, whether you are using Windows, Linux or macOS. If this kind of tutorial helps you, please do consider subscribing to my channel or leave a comment down below. With that said, let's dive into it.
Right off the bat, if you want to make backup of your SD card, there is no real safe way to do that while it's still in running Raspberry Pi. That has to do with file system consistency. Basically, safe way to do this here is having physical access to the Raspberry Pi and to the SD card. So we will turn off our Raspberry Pi with this command, sudo power off. That will shut down it safely. Don't just unplug it from the power source. You could possibly corrupt data on your SD card and in the worst case scenario, make the whole Pi unbootable. Now let's take the SD card out and attach it to the computer on which you'll do your backup. You might need some kind of adapter like this one or this one. Okay, how to backup your SD card on Windows? We'll use something that is called Windows 32 Disk Imager. You can download it from this page. Link is in the description below. Install and launch it. Choose which device you want to backup. In my case, it's E device, and I'll back it up just to downloads directory. You might just want to pick the destination you deem fit, maybe something safer than downloads folder. I'm just demonstrating the steps. Set backup file name, let's say Raspberry Pi backup 287.2022.img and hit open. And now to start the backup process itself, hit the read button. Time it takes will vary depending on a few things like size of the SD card and so on. Okay, so now the backup is complete and we could verify if the file was correctly created. Let's check our downloads folder. And here it is, it's Raspberry Pi backup date.img. And restoring the image is quite simple. Run Win32 Disk Imager, pick your device, locate your backup file and hit write button. Yep, it's that simple. That's it for Windows. Now how to do this on Mac OS. The backup process will be similar to Windows, but we'll use different tools. Fire up your Mac. I'll use this microSD to SD card adapter and attach the microSD card to my Mac as my MacBook does have the SD card reader built in. Maybe you'll need some other kind of adapter to attach the microSD card to your Mac. Open Disk Utility, hit View, Show All Devices or just press Command 2. You see this Apple SD XC Reader Media, that's the device I want to backup. Name of yours might be a little different. And go File, New Image, Image from Apple SD XC Reader Media and save as Raspberry Pi backup date. For the format you choose DVD/CD master and hit save. Okay, the backup's done. Let me just check the file. Here it is. If you plan to use this file with different operating systems, it could be a good idea to rename it to .iso. You can safely do that, you will not corrupt the file, and ISO is widely supported image format. Eject the SD card and that's it for macOS. How to do the backup on Linux. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'll use Debian-based Kali Linux distribution, but the terminal commands are so basic it will work for almost any other popular Linux distribution. Open terminal and write lsblk. This will show you information about your book devices. You see, I've got my main SDA disk here. Now I'll attach my SD card to the computer and run lsblk again. And now we see here new SDB device with two partitions. That's the SD card we want to backup. If you connected SD card directly to your computer, it could be named something like MMCBLK0. or similar. That's the SD card. So to backup this device, you just use this command: sudo dd input file dev sdb output file home Raspberry Pi backup date.img. Actually, I'll just stop the backup process by hitting Ctrl C, because we can do this a little bit better. We want to see the progress of the backup process. Use this command: sudo dd bs, that means block size, input file dev sdb, output file Raspberry Pi backup date.img, status equals progress. Dd is the cloning command we use. Its name is based on data definition statement. BS stands for block size, set it to 4 megabytes. IF stands for input file, that's the device we want to backup. OF stands for output file, that's the location and file name of our backup file. Status equals progress shows us details about progression of the backup. And just hit enter, type in your sudo password and wait. Small hint, if you do this in virtual machine in a virtual box like me, don't forget to install a VirtualBox extension pack and enable USB 3.0 on your virtual machine. If you don't do this, there's a good chance the backup DD process will fail with a reading error. And it's done.
That's it for today. Now you know how to backup your SD card on all three major operating systems. If you need help with any other topic, please leave a comment down below. Thanks for watching. I hope you will never lose your data again. Please do consider hitting that like button and take care.